Welcome back.
Fish tails fly tying. I'm going to tie a couple flies based on this new weedless process I've recently discovered. Somebody's been doing this for a while, but I saw it for the first time about a week ago. And I will tell you, it shows more promise than anything I've done before. Now we got to get a little adjustment there. Okay. How's that? I'll tell you what, let's bring this down just a tad bit right there. It starts like any other fly. 210, man. I got a bunch of 140 coming. I hope it's strong enough. My type of tying. You're only going to use about half the hook, and you're going to come back and cut this off, so concentrate on the front half. First step is to run. Well, dang it. See, they're done messed up the first step. The first step is to take this hook and bend the eye. Grab a hold of that rascal like that, right on the eye. And try not to skewer yourself, but get it bent back like this. Luckily, that's a step you can go back and do after you've threaded up your hook real nice. Come on, vise. I got a new vise coming, too. Got a nice little rotary vise coming. $50, so it ain't that nice. I looked up. I saw a video on an HMH. Wow, ain't no way I can justify a $300 tying vise, even no matter how nice it is. All right, we're gonna put that out the front and latch it in. And with this design, this is enough. There will never be anything on this fly that pulls it, so it's not gonna go anywhere. Okay, and we cut the back off. I'm going to tie a frog fly to start. Well, no, I'm going to do the muddler first. The same. This will be Mutt Muddler version number 6. And I hope it does better than version number 5, because it did not function right at all. And I am leaving every bit of this feather on here. I'm going to get the mass on the back of the fly. I want this thing to have some decent sized tails. There we go. Form them together. Like that. Match up the ends. Did it stay put? Yeah, it did. That's as far back on that fly as I'm going. I don't have to worry about the hook eye being exposed because I don't tie to that. Okay. This is going to be a real simple one because I think I've been over tying them. All right, let's get two of these. I've been adding too much material for what I'm looking to mimic. Looks good. And even though the feathers really compact, you know, when you throw it in the water and you drag it out of the water, it looks like the feathers are, you know, they all blend together. They slim down a lot. But that don't matter, because in the water it looks great. As soon as it hits the water, they flare out like they're doing right now. All right, let me get a little bit of the coyote tail to start with. I think I'll just bury this. I'm just going to tie it on, sweeping back. I'm going to go ahead and give that a little angle, so that it will compress down real nice. that out a little. Okay. Let me get two of these green ones. Two of the real nice tight color ones, two of these, yeah. And put that down each side just underneath. Didn't lay right. Try again. It might work. That's okay. We'll let it turn down a little. Alright. Wrap that one underneath. A couple of long. Beautiful. Okay. Believe it or not, that is all I'm doing to this part of the fly. I could put a hackle on it. I probably should put a hackle on it. Maybe a green one. Get one of these big ones. Maybe a red hackle. Maybe one of these hackles. Throw a little yellow in there. Yeah, let's throw this one in there. Let's run this as a hackle and give this thing some color right up behind the head. You won't be able to see much of this, so I'm going to use it. This will just give it nice color. Sorry about that. Didn't mean to bop the camera. There we go. Alright. Tiny bit of color. Oh, come on, Vice. Hang on to my fly. Uh-oh, here comes Buddy. He's going to be coming up in my lap. Oh, there he is. Buddy, what are you doing? Can't you see him tying flies? He said, yeah, I can help with that. Well, no, you don't help. You don't help. Matter of fact, you make it harder. Okay, that added just a little bit of yellow in there. That'll be buried down fairly deep. Alright, let me... Buddy, I gotta whip this. Whip it good. Whip it good. Do a second one, just good measure. Alright. There we go. Okay, there is the back of the fly. Pay no attention to that, because when it hits the water, it will slim up. And they should stay fairly well together. How's your side look? Looks nice. Okay. Now, what we do is we get our worm hook. These things. Super wide gap. This is a number two. Needle point. And man, these things are sharp. It don't take much of nothing to get that to... Oh, my well just turned on. To get this thing in you. This is also a light wire hook. Probably takes about 20 pounds of pull to straighten that hook out. But with a fly rod, that's pretty significant. Alright, all we need to do now is reach up underneath here. Reach up underneath here. And hey, buddy. Oh, now look at what you're doing. Come on, stay down. You're lucky we don't get a hook in you. Alright, here we go. I'm going to hold the hook part of it. Oh, dadgummit. I got to get it further in there. There we go. There. See? That way you don't lose this piece. That piece doesn't go flying. There. Now the hook's been removed from this. I can also tell which way this fly wants to orient. See, this is supposed to be the bottom like this. Alright. Now you get this little old worm hook. And I'll smash the bottom. Probably going to do one additional tie to this. Buddy, you're not helping me none. Come on. Put it in here upside down. Way back in the vise. Double check to make sure we're still looking in the right spot. Yeah, perfect. Okay. Buddy, you ain't helping me. Alright. Now don't start grabbing at my stuff. You thread this part of the hook up right here. Now here's the one. Buddy's gonna knock my camera around. Buddy, don't mess with my camera. What's it look like back there, huh? Go ahead and... All right, buddy. You are gonna mess something up, cat. Come on. Oh, shit. See that what I mean there, buddy? Dadgum you. Messing around. Break my camera, buddy. I'll have to hurt you. Yeah, I'll have to hurt you. Okay. If I put you down, will you stay down there? No. I'm gonna do it anyway. What do you think, buddy? Inspection. Okay, get out of here. Stay out of my way. Crazy cat. Alright, that's the top. That's the bottom. So we're going to tie this in right here. Now, buddy, you ain't making this any easier. I got to check to make sure I still see what's going on. Cat, you a pain in the ass. Alright, I think I'm still okay. Alright. Have you ever tied with a cat in your lap? Bring my... I'm going to rethink trying something different this time. Alright. We are going to secure that. Hoping you can see this better. Boy, that damn device of mine ain't worth a darn. Alright. I gotta make sure it stays oriented. Twist it up, because see what it does? It rides right on top of that hook. The fly actually covers the hook. And this is literally all it takes to hold that mono, to hold that fly in place. Now I got a piece of mono in there, it's blocking the hooks, but that's all right. Alright, now all I gotta do is put a head on here. And I kinda wonder what I wanna use to do that. Let me think about it for a minute. Okay, well, I didn't restart the camera. I don't know how much you missed. Basically, that's coyote tail. You can use deer hair, coyote tail, there's all kinds of ways. You can spin it, you can not spin it, you can do whatever you want. Alright, well, there it goes. It's getting loose on me. Did I get... Nope, that's okay. Alright, I'm going to spread that. Spread that. I'm going to take my super glue. This is a shortcut. This is an easy way to make this hair stay back the way I want it without having to do all kind of fancy footwork. Basically, I coat that face of this fly with super glue, and that will hold that hair back and in place. Then I can just put a regular nice little thread head on this thing. And there we almost have Mutt Muddler version 6. Okay. I don't know how much you missed. I don't think you missed much. I put that red collar on there underneath here. This part of the fly moves around easily. Let me pull it all up out of the way. Okay. Wait a minute. Let's get this right here. There we go. Get that one on the right side. Where'd my other little green feather go? It's supposed to be on the outside. There. There is a Mutt Muddler version 6. Lots of layers. It'll ride in the water, the hook up, hook point up. At least that's the intention. And this will keep it from snagging anything. That seems to be... Let me wiggle this thing up a little more. There, now it's staying put. Boy, the frogs are already going at it. There you go. Okay. That is Mutt Muddler version 6. Now, let's do a simple frog fly with this stuff. This one I'm going to speed through. This will probably be if all the indications I'm getting from these first few flies that I've tied this way, all the indications are that this is a very good weedless design. Way better than anything else I've done. All right, first step. Let's take that hook. I'm going to try doing this one the other way. I'm going to try bending it down like this and then build the fly on top. All right, boy, I hope that new vise hangs on to these hooks better than this one. All right, where'd my mono go? Cat probably knocked it down. Same thing. You don't want to go very far back. This fly is really going to be split between front and back. Oh, let's see. There's my mono. No, that's not what I'm looking for. This is. Okay. 25 pound test monofilament. And I don't really think that I'll ever see one of these flies break the mono. They might come untied. All right, now what we're gonna do on this one, we're gonna extend it out further because I think I am gonna do a loop method on this one. All right. You know what? And if that is the case, what I need to do is loop it back through here like this. Yep. Anchor this real well because there will be tension on this. Not much. All right. There we go. Let's cut this. Now, see on that one, I got a loop. I'm still gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna anchor that in, but that'll give me more room up front for the foam when I build a foam head on this thing. All right, I gotta make sure I do not cut that line. All right, this will be a very simple frog fly with stripy legs and deer hair, a bucktail. Let me dig out my yellow, there it is. That didn't take long. Yellow bucktail. I'm gonna put a good bunch of this at the tail end of this fly. And I think I'd be best served by putting it on this way because I really need it to hold those legs apart. And a short distance from the end. All right, so I'm gonna do is even the ends up. Let me get my serrated scissors. They will work better. Pachow, pachow. Okay, nice and even. Let's see if we can get them to stay this way. That is just at the end of that fly, and it's just there to hold the legs apart. If I get it, what I might end up having to do is when I put it on the other hook, I may have to shorten this just a little bit so that it's in front of the hook. ahead and give this thing a good meaty size body. Use all that deer hair, double back on itself so that it's well. See, now the diameter of that hook is big. Now I got a good spread on there. I did not extend past my thread. I got a nice arch to him. Here's Buddy. Get down, Buddy. I can't have you in my lap when I'm trying to tie flies. Good Lord. Okay, there's one. Tag the ends together. Get them about right. Oh, now there you go again, Buddy. You're going to make a mess. You're going to knock my camera down. I'm going to have to hurt you. Yeah, I'm going to have to hurt you. No, don't do it. Buddy, 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 quit that. God, you are a pest. You're being a pest. Yeah, you are. I don't care. Let me put you in the house. I'll tell you what. Y'all hold on. I'm going to put the cat in the house.
All right. Back in action.
Buddy's got dinner. That's what he was so excited about. He was waiting for his dinner. All right, yeah, we look good there. Pretty good, pretty good. June bugs crawling around the box, which the bugs are going to start coming in. You watch. I need to get this done pretty quick. This is my last one I'm tying anyway. Okay. Oh, probably it wouldn't hurt to have a couple of hackles. I need to see if I got some longer feather type hackles. Ooh, I think I'm going to throw a couple of these in there. That's the problem with having so many different kind of flies. Oh yeah, these are my good legs. I'm going to double up my legs. I'm going to have a pair of these on each side for longer legs. Good Lord, those are tough. See, we'll put these in here in conjunction with these. Ooh, that'll look good. There we go. Let me get another one for the other side. How long did I go? I went pretty long. Let's get it way in there. Oh yeah, okay. Just add a little more illusion to the fly. A little better legs looking, a little better looking legs. You know, another pair of these smaller ones might be easy to add since I've already got them. Oh, that one really rolled. Oh, bugs are one thing. Mosquito bugs are something altogether. That's what I just had land on my head. Come on, feather. There, now you're acting right. These things in here. Oh yeah, here we go. Love it. All right, lots of nice feathers here. Those are probably riding a little higher. What in the world is crawling around out there? There we go. All right. Now let's take another one of these and give it some, make a hackle out of one of these. That one just volunteered right here. The So give it just a little more body up underneath the foam. New concept. Whoa, lost my grip. Yeah, I'm going to end up moving this back in the house. The bugs are going to be a problem. Move this operation back in the comfort of the house. It was fine when it was cooler, but now that it's warmer, I've got visitors. Okay, here we go. Now we're going to figure out how to mount the foam head. Let me wrap this up. Okay, that's good. Go ahead and give it just a little bit of super glue. Work that in. Okay. Reach up underneath here. Pull all my stuff out of the way. Reach up in here real far as I can. There's a mosquito right on me right there. Cut that off. That's my little piece. And there we go. That is the back half of a frog fly. Now, let's tie it to the other hook. Oh man, the bugs are crawling all over me. I'm not going to last out here very long. Okay. Let's flatten the barb. Try to get it back in the vise a long way. Oh yeah. There we go. Oh, damn it. This little vise is really a pain in the butt. Okay. It's hard to get just right. Alright, let's thread the hook up. I'm just going to stay right in this area. Right here. Now what's different on this is I am going to run this through. Right, is that the way I want it? I believe I do. See, I'm putting this, I'm going to capture both of these monos, and I'm actually going to tie into that. It's going to want to twist a little bit to one side. I'm going to tie right to that, but I'm also going to have some foam covering it. Alright, we're going to get real creative with the foam. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's going to work perfect. That is perfect. Every bit of that fly sits right in that deer hair. That's going to work great. And it should stay oriented in the water just the way I need it to. Or close to it. Doesn't hardly matter if it turns a little bit to one side or the other. When that bass sees that thing climbing up over a weed or up on a lily pad, he's going to stomp on it. All right, we're going to tie this. Do a good whip. Now, one thing you got to be careful is super glue and monofilament does not mix. Goodbye, mosquito. I got some bug spray. Maybe I'll put some on. Get these bugs out of my face. There he is again. I'm gonna get in my fly. Alright. Now I'm gonna have to do something real special with the phone. Let me think about this a little bit. It's gonna have to come up and then back over without being attached to this, but still look like it's part of it. Probably ought to do a foam head or a deer hair head, but I think I can get better results with foam. Let's cut a strip. Deja vu. Alright. Now that should be enough. That is a problem. You know what? I don't think foam's gonna work because it doesn't flex. This part of the fly flexes like it's supposed to. Yeah, you know what? That's not gonna work. That's coming off. Think about a foam fly, huh? Redirect real fast. It is well glued on there. Yep, I'm gonna have to spin a head on this thing. Alright. At least that's not back to the drawing board, that's just back to the vise. Come on. Come on, little icy. There we go. Alright. Alright, I'm gonna have to put a deer hair head on it. So let's get a good wrap. Okay. Pull this. Probably should put another hackle on it. Let's put another hackle on it. Cover up that joint, fill in behind it. Use a different kind of hackle. I need something that's more hackly. Alright, let's get a good... good spray of this stuff right here. One more. There we go. Okay. That looks okay. Let's pull that back a little. All right. Now, let's get our deer body hair. Some of this stuff right here. And let's try to get a good big clump of it. Let's try to work it all at once. One big clump. Oh Lord, there's a big bug flying around. Sound like a 747. All right, big clump. I'm gonna attempt to knock all the crap out of it. I'm going to put that right here and try to get one good... Oh, damn, I hate when that happens. I went beyond the design of the thread. Hopefully that'll hold in position until I get this thing more thread on it. God damn it. This is only one... This is 210. Holy crap, that... 140 I picked up. Not gonna be strong enough. this out of the video here in a second. How'd you notice how I did that? All right, let's get right in here and get some good wraps on this. All right, we'll push all this back best we can. Okay, now what I want to do is go ahead and harden the head on this thing with my super glue. Well, I stuck it to my fingers. There we go. Now, I think what I'm going to do to start with is leave that, well, I'm going to trim it some, but I'm going to leave a lot of that in place. Look at that. I'm going to try to cut the bottom of it flat. All right, a couple half hitches. A little more super glue on the threads themselves. I got a mosquito in my ear. Now he's on my hand. Man, I gotta get out of here. Okay. Alright, that don't look like much. And it might not be much. Let me give it a little haircut. Unruly ones out of the way. Right, now I'm going to darken the head quite a bit. I'm going to mark this thing up some. Getting all kinds of creative here. Looks like an Indian chief. All right, that's good enough for this one. I've had enough of mosquito biting me. All right, so there's a somewhat like a muddler looking fly. Not much like a muddler, but it's gonna work good, I bet. And there's my frog fly. That. I don't know. We'll see. Maybe they'll work.